Hi guys, this is Dipen Goy, technical analyst of Aliceblue. So in this video I'll discuss about bank Nifty. So you can see this is a bank Nifty 15 minute time frame. So a small announcement and a request to you, and every day evening I will analyze market, right? Like morning I'm analyzing market, but evening I'll analyze market in a different YouTube channel. So I'm giving this link below. You just go there in description page and subscribe this channel, right? So in that channel evening I will analyze this market, right? So please you subscribe my another YouTube channel, which is I'm going to analyze in evening time, right? Okay, let's get start here. So now you can see this is a bank Nifty 15 minute time frame. Now we have seen bank Nifty is running in an uptrend, right? Creating higher high, higher low, like higher high, higher low. Right now here we have seen a little more like that, lower high and lower low somewhere. But question is that, is the price will continue toward the downside, or if or price will bounce from this area? So that is the most important. Most of the people are thinking price already running in a downtrend, so we can go for buy again or we can sell again, right? So let me explain or let me analyze in which direction we can go for buy or sell, in which direction, right? So before we enter in this market, we have to find out support and resistance and candlestick pattern and market trend and range, most important thing, right? So let me explain, right? Now let's see, this is the daily time frame, right? And in a daily time frame, the price is running in a downtrend. Most of the people are thinking by seeing this small time frame, like 5 minute, 15 minute, hey, price is running in an uptrend, let's go for buy. Not exactly. So first we have to find out in a daily, what is the trend and where is the supporting and resistant area are there, right? Right now we can see here trend is down, but we have seen double bottom pattern are there. In this double bottom, or most of the people are saying this is W pattern, or both are same, right? So in that case we are looking for break this neckline, that is called neckline. So still price is below this neckline, they are not able to break this level. So in that case we can buy suddenly here, somewhere here, right? We can't enter suddenly, right? So trend is down in a large time frame. I'm not talking in a small time frame, I'm talking about this large time frame, like daily. So now question is that in a daily time frame we have seen here a candlestick pattern. This is most important thing. When this type of candlestick pattern appear in a downtrend, and I always say that candlestick pattern should be appear in a right place, but problem is there. Here most of the people are confusing, right? Who don't have proper knowledge, right? Most of the people are thinking, hey, this is a trend is down, and now we have seen inverted hammer, right? Or say most of the people are saying doji pattern, whatever, right? This is a candlestick pattern. If you know the behavior of this candle, right? So right now we have seen trend is down, and we have seen a candlestick pattern which is called inverted hammer. So it is a high probability to fail the price from this area. But another, we have seen another sign. What we have seen here, this candlestick pattern form above this resistance line. We are looking for this type of candlestick pattern must form below this supporting line, right? This is supporting line, right? SL. sorry, don't think stop loss. This is all supporting. Oh, sorry, resistance line. It is supporting line, right? So we are looking for this type of candle, stick pattern. They must form below this supporting line, right? And now we have seen this candle are forming above this resistance. Now big confused, right? And the trend is down, forming this type of candle, good sign, but places where above this resistance, very confused, right? So let me explain. Now we have seen this type of candle, when they are forming, we are looking for sell below this candle. Remember, below this candle, below this EVS candle, right? And for the buy, we are looking for above this candle, right? Let me draw this candle and pull down toward, this is our buy entry above, remember. And let me sell a little more here. I will start selling below this candle, right? And now in a 4 hour time frame, we have seen what we have seen. So let me remove this one. We have seen our entry point, right? Entry and exit point. Now we have seen this is our above our buy entry, and below this is our sell entry. In this zone, especially most of the traders who have less knowledge, the people are never enter in this area. They are looking for sell below, buy above, right? That is our entry zone. Now let's check it in a small time frame, like 4 hour. 4 hour we have seen some candlestick, it is called. What is called this one? One black crop, right? Remember that candlestick pattern? I often use this. This was one black crow candlestick pattern. After that market boom, right? Here we have seen this is called one black crow market, right? Again we have seen market one black crow candlestick pattern are forming, and the high probability to fail the price from that area, and they are trying to create triple bottom. Most of the people are thinking, hey, they form double bottom, they will go up right there, right? But sometime what happened, they are create triple bottom earlier, one, twice, third, right? They are forming like that. Now that is why by seeing this one, we can enter in this market for the sell. Remember, we have to find out our entry point. So I give an entry point here, 27593. If they cross this level, and we will start selling, right? So who people are option trader will start buying put option, right? And another, if they break this level, so we'll start buying. That means they are not following this candlestick pattern, right? That is the important thing. Good. Now let's check it. 15 minute time frame for entry and exit. Now, in a 15 minute time frame, when I'm not placing this candle's horizontal line by using 200 exponential moving average, right? In a 15 minute, I'm using by according the daily basis, right? Have you seen? This is daily basis. So we have seen here some support are there. So that is why I place, and 15 minute, they are showing 200 moving average, right? And then now you can see, I told you start selling below that one. That means this area is called no traded zone. Most of the people are thinking, hey, why I miss almost 500 point? How can I miss that 500 point? This is a big point, right? Most of the people are thinking. But in this area, there is no confirmation. If we are not getting any confirmation, then why will enter in this market? Leave it 500 point. That is not a big deal, right? Instead of taking 500 point, you might go loss, right? That is the most important thing. So we need a high probability trade. And in this area, we never seen any high probability trade. anything happen in this market, might be they run like that, right? So that is the most important thing. That is called fear of missing out. That is the psychology factor. Most of the people are thinking, hey, I'll miss this opportunity, 500 point. How can I miss that one? I don't have person to wait. I'll start buying right now. That is called fear of missing, and avoid that psychology, right? And a 15 minutes time frame, we have a candlestick pattern, right? You just think about 2 to 3 seconds, what candlestick pattern are forming. And these candlestick pattern are forming in a right place in a small time frame, right? So definitely I'll tell you what candlestick pattern are forming. So now we have seen by counting this candle, two candle, what candle are there? This is called bullish harami pattern, right? If you don't have any idea, you just visit to our Ant IQ page and read that candlestick pattern. This is called bullish harami pattern, right? So what is the logic behind that? Where is our entry point? When they will break this level, so we have seen this is bullish harami pattern are covering this area, right? This area, in this area, this is called never, no traded area, don't trade. Always buy above this area, but near in that area entry point, we have seen this is a small gap, right? So I don't enter in this area, I always enter above this area, right? That is our buy, and breakout will start sell, right? So I hope you enjoy this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And again, I want to say you just subscribe my another channel, which is I already given in description below. You just subscribe it every day evening time I'm analyzing market, right, in that channel. So that is why you just subscribe. Thanks for watching.